Hello Leos, welcome to my channel Surabhi, and in this video we'll be having a look at the messages for you in the month of May. And as I've joined Patreon also, so the extended readings are also being done, and if this reading resonates with you, you are most welcome to listen to it on the extended at Patreon. So looking forward to your support on Patreon also. So let's see. Anyway, I was just engrossed in the messages, what is there in store for Leos. For the month of May, what's in store, what can be expected for Leos? So we have the Three of Swords, the Lovers, the Five of Swords, okay. Eight of Pentacles, the Queen of Pentacles, the King of Wands, the Ace of Wands, the Death and Rebirth, and the Ace of Swords. The Solios, you are dealing with a relationship which is which has some sort of it's at least more than 6 months old. Okay, so you are dealing with a relationship, maybe even more than that, maybe more than a year or so, but yes, it has some roots to it. It's not a new meeting or a new couple type of a thing. This is a relationship which you are dealing with, which was really very beautiful, I should say. I'm saying was because we have the Three of Swords and the Five of Swords here. So as for now, it doesn't seem to be beautiful. There is something wrong going on with this relationship, and which is causing you a lot of heartache. So this relationship is sort of at stake. We'll see if it is or not in the clarify, while we clarify on Patreon. But yes, as for now, things, energies are not very good. There has been some sort of manipulation, some mind games are going on. Somebody is trying to have their own way. Maybe somebody is being bossy, but whatever the situation is, there is a lot of heartache in this relationship, and maybe to both of you, that is the vibe I'm getting. Okay, maybe both of you are upset because of this. But yes, manipulations, mind games, and that is self-sabotaging type of an energy. This is sabotaging your own relationship. If anybody is playing mind games, anybody is trying to manipulate the other person, then they're just sabotaging this relationship. Okay, and then we have the Eight of Pentacles, the Queen of Pentacles, and the King of Wands. So what I feel here is definitely you are working hard, maybe building up your finances, since it is the first thing which I'm getting here is maybe since you know that these things are at stake, you're trying to make yourself busy in other things, focusing on your other stabilities, your financial matters and other things. For others of you, yes, definitely you are trying to mend this relationship perhaps. Okay, you're trying to mend this relationship, and with the Queen of Pentacles and the King of Wands, what I feel is that it seems to be a sort of a, maybe sort of introspection, okay, what can be done, what should be done, how to make a move, what to do, what not to do type of a thing. So this is a person who is sitting here and contemplating as to what should I do of the finances which I have established, or what should I do of the investments I have put in this relationship. It's sort of you worked hard on it, and now you really don't know what to do, which way to go, what should I do. It's something like that. So it can be talking about actually the financial aspect in this relationship, the finances and all, or because you're trying to focus on them, diverting your attention from this. It can be that. For others of you, it is like you build up this relationship slowly and slowly. You have invested in this relationship, okay, and now you are just having a look as to what should I do, what's going wrong, how can it be corrected type of a thing. And with the King of Wands, I really feel that you are trying to take back the control. You are trying to take back the control and the power of the relationship. And one more thing is, maybe you just think of giving it a second shot and have a new beginning. We have the Ace of Wands here, so maybe you think that okay, I can do it this way, can we start over once again type of a thing. but there is a huge transformation here with the death and rebirth and the ace of swords. So maybe once you, it can go two ways. We'll clarify that on Patreon what that is. But then yes, definitely what I feel here is that you do want to have a new beginning, and maybe this effort of yours changes the entire scenario, because after the death again we have the ace of swords. So maybe once you are able to talk and once you are able to decide that no, I really want to have a new beginning, maybe the whole scenario changes. Things are, whatever was there is and ends, and you have the clarity after the communication, and you have a communication regarding this situation, and you have the clarity, okay, this is how we should move ahead. It can be that also. And so this is being this is a major transition phase here. So maybe something is ending, maybe what the old ways are ending, maybe how you were taking this relationship forward has ended, because I really don't see any it is not much of a committed or a marriage type of a situation. It is a lover's energy only. So maybe you just talk it over and decide, okay, this is how we should move ahead this time, and you have the clarity to do that, and maybe that is a major change which is shifting the perspective and the energy of the relationship towards better. It can be that also. For others of you, it can be that maybe things don't work out and you have the clarity that, okay, I need to move forward. So we'll see that on Patreon. We'll clarify how things go, what it is. But definitely one thing is for sure, that something is definitely going wrong here in this relationship, and somebody really wants to mend it. Somebody really wants to mend it. They really do want to have a new beginning. We'll see while we clarify that, are you able to have that new beginning with the same person or not? Okay, let's see what is the message from this deck for you. The Sun. Oh, this is ultimate happiness. Now this is really important here, as to what is the source of happiness, getting back together or moving new, because we have the Death card here definitely. So there is a major change happening in this relationship, that is for sure. Now what is that change, that we'll have to see. That is very interesting. Let's see what is the guidance from the angels for you. Two of Action. Trust in your ability to make excellent choices. There is an opportunity all around you if you just continue to move forward. It may be time to take a new partner who can help you be a success in your career or creative endeavors. Keep your eyes on the big picture rather than the details of the moment. Now this is adding fuel to the fire as to, is it the same person or is it someone new? So Leos, if you are really interested and if this reading resonates with you, and if you're really interesting as to how things move forward, please join me on Patreon. You're most welcome there. And for those of you who are who wish to end it here, so thank you for being here, and I just hope it helps. Bye.